Hi everyone, Yotam here. Today I want to go over some cool methods for creating topographies using the environment for Revit's topography tools. I'm only going to go over ways to create new topographies or adding elevation points to your existing ones. There are more tools which allow you to edit existing points in bulk or modifying your topography as a whole, but I will cover those in a different video. Okay? Okay. So, when you're clicking on the Topography Tools button, a panel will open up. Generally, you don't have to leave this panel until your topography is done. You can just keep adding, deleting, or editing points using the different features. Once you're pleased with the result, you can hit finish. Sweet. Now let's see what we have here. Okay, the first one is easy because it's similar to the native place point feature in Revit. I'm actually not going to spend much time talking about this one because I rarely use it, only when I need to add a single elevation point somewhere. But since we're talking topographies, it's worth mentioning. Basically, once you assign the elevation, you're manually placing elevation points. It's very tedious if you're trying to create a large-scale smooth topographies. So next, we have the Add Line feature. This feature will let you select model lines in your model and insert elevation points along them. Back in the old AutoCAD days, we had to draw each contour line individually. With this tool, you can reduce a significant amount of work by drawing some lines in different elevations and adding them into your topography. In this case, I'm creating a topography from scratch, but it will also work with adding additional lines into your existing topography. Notice that there is an option to let environment determine how many points will be added along the line with a smart point option. This option will optimize the amount of points along the lines in order to create the smoothest topography with the lowest amount of points. However, if you want to override those parameters, you can always select custom settings and define your preferred distance between the points as well. Third, we have the From Edge feature. Pretty self-explanatory. This tool is allowing you to place points along existing model edges in your project. Any 3D edge, slabs, topographies, walls, even linked Revit or CAD files. Sometimes you want your topography to have an offset. So, like in this example, you can do that here. Furthermore, something that is really cool is that you can also select contour lines, which is useful in a whole different way. Fourth, we have the Pick Face feature. Similar to the From Edge, also here you can add points to your topography from existing elements in your model. This time, faces. It can be a roof, floor, or other surfaces, even a mess. Again, you have control over the accuracy, which basically means the amount of elevation points. With this tool, you can add topography on top or underneath objects in your model in a matter of seconds. Cool, next. Fifth, we have the Insert Midpoints feature. Some might say the most useful feature for fine-tuning our topography. Unlike the previous tools, this one won't let you create a topography from scratch. After all, you need some elevation points in order to insert midpoints between them. So, what this tool does is figure out the best distribution for the added points in order to create a smooth surface, depending on the distance between them, the height difference, and the rest of the elevation points in your topography. Also here, you can choose the density and arc, as you can see in this example. Sixth, we have the Slope Path tool. This tool lets you add points along a path based on a slope value, like in this example, or a predefined start and end values. Also here, you would need at least one elevation point, your starting point. And again, you have the flexibility to arc your vector to fit your design. The cool thing is that before you hit insert points, it'll show you the slope or elevation, so you can make sure it aligns with your plan. By the way, unlike this example, it is recommended to work on a floor plan view, or if you're working in 3D, to set your view to top. It makes it easier to use. Now, a bonus. Before we continue, I want to jump back and go over the Edit Sketch tool. This is only relevant to Revit 2024 and up. Unlike Revit's native Edit Sketch tool, which will erase all elevation points outside of your boundary, here the original topography is saved in the background, so you can always go back and make more changes. With the Edit Sketch feature in the Environment Topography tools, you can keep your existing surface and elevation points while only editing the sketch. Super, super useful. You know what? I wasn't planning on it, but here's another quick example. You can clearly see how you can have full control over the terrain by modifying the elevation separately from your sketch. So now let's go to 7, the Mesh Reference Surface tool, which is also only relevant to Revit 2024 and up. The standard approach to site modeling is looking at the entire site as a tapestry made out of different toposolids and not just one big surface. A landscape architecture BIM model should incorporate multiple topography types, similar to the diversity of floor or wall types typically used in a project. This feature allows you to quickly copy elevation points and slopes from one toposolid to another, which can save tons of time. That's about it, folks. I hope you enjoyed this quick tutorial. If you do, please like and subscribe. I will also add a link to our user guide in the description below. If there is any subject you would like us to break down for you, please let us know in the comment section. And make sure to check out our channel. There are a bunch of useful tutorials. All right, see you.